Dave Hughes! Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Wonderful to be here.
Nothing was going to stop me turning up tonight.
So last time you were here, you were in a finger brace.
Yeah, so that finger's still broken. but I thought I'd complete the set by doing my shoulder. So, yeah.
What happened?
Look, it was a harrowing story. It was more harrowing than the finger, which was done taking a sock off.
You are falling apart.
No, the shoulder was surfing. I was surfing in Queensland, Gold Coast, New Year's Eve, and... I dislocated my shoulder surfing out there in the wild. Wow. Surf, yeah. Oh. I mean, the only thing that saved me from drowning was my own courage and the fact I was in knee-deep water. So, so my own surfboard attacked me from behind, took a wave without me, thought it was a better surfer than I was, and dislocated my shoulder. Oh. And I sat on the beach for an hour. Oh. An hour? Oh. Can I tell you, they didn't have that green whistle. You know that green whistle they have on Bondi Rescue?
Yes. The fun vape.
Well, the Queensland... apparently the Queensland Lifesavers have partied too hard. And they didn't have it. So I was for an hour and a half so sore. It was terrible. I got a buggy. I said to the surfer, like, just take me somewhere. And he got me on his buggy and drove me down Cavill Avenue.
What, to take your mind off things?
What's that?
To take your mind off
things. Not for a scenic tour. I wanted to find a medical clinic. And I wandered into one. I staggered into one and said, drugs, I don't care. Give me something. I'll have the COVID vaccine. I don't know. I just wanted something to take my mind off it. Yeah. But, yeah, so 2 hours later, the ambulance found me at the clinic and my shoulder got put back in. But that was a month ago, and only a week ago I realised that maybe I hadn't paid attention in my exit interview a month ago. Yeah, and I've really had completely torn all my rotator cuff and stuff. The surgeon I spoke to today said it's one of the worst he's ever seen in 40 years. So I was pretty proud of that. and so, yeah, I just got out of hospital, guys.
Is that why you've still got a hospital band?
I just got out of hospital. I like to keep these on.
I thought you'd been a big day out or something.
That's my hospital. I've got one on my leg as well. Anyway, I've got I've got a foot one as well. So I just got out. But, yeah.
How'd it go? How'd the surgery go?
Apparently it was a really tough job, but he reckons he did a great job. So,
Would he have told you if he did a bad job?
I don't know. There's a 90% chance that it's going to go perfectly. So.
Right, did you listen to the exit interview this time?
I did this time, absolutely. Yeah, good.
Now, you are sporting an excellent sling, but, Hughesy, there's someone else who's been sporting a sling recently at some very top-notch award ceremonies. It's the Internet Daddy Pedro Pascal.
Oh, yeah.
Do you think that you wear it better, or is it Pedro?
Hughesy, I don't want to be rude. That's the bloke from Last of Us next to the zombie from Last of Us.
Look, I think there's room enough in the world for two hot guys in slings. That's all I'll say. So, but that was me on stage like 2 days after the initial accident. So, you know, I'm on stage at Taronga Zoo on Saturday night. Back on the radio this morning on Hughesy, Ed and Aaron in Sydney on 2 Day FM. I can't be stopped.
You never stop.
They give you at the hospital,
They gave me some, but I'm running out. You can't have too many of those.
Speaking of celebrating, your daughter just turned 11.
Yes.
What did you do to celebrate?
Well, I was in a sling and I thought, if we haven't suffered enough, let's go to a cat cafe. I don't know if you guys have ever been to a cat cafe. That's me trying to entertain cats. So, there's like 24 cats who don't want to be there. And the guy said, try to entertain them, you know. They're a tough crowd. And they are a tough crowd. But I was just trying to make them happy. So, yeah. But anyway, the cat cafe is available for anyone who loves cats.
So you go there and they make you work?
Yes, they get paid. They obviously work. I don't know if they get paid, but they're getting fed.
And the cats get paid.
And you've got to work. It's disappointing.
Well, that finger was wrecked and this arm's in a sling. Were you at the cat cafe just to use the litter box?
Yeah. No, there wasn't a litter box, but I declined the muffins they offered.
You've got a lot going on. You're a busy guy.
Yes.
How do you manage?
By just continuing to work. I do that because I'm desperately insecure. So, so that's why I turn up to work today, to make sure they weren't having a good time without me. So, I love doing stand-up comedy. I love doing radio. I love doing TV, you know. I mean, I used to sit on this panel every night. Yes, absolutely. Yes, I had to tell you only produces that.
Do you sleep?
Do I sleep? No, I do, especially the moment on the endone. I'm a much better sleeper than I used to be. What I do is I close my eyes and I treat my own mind as a movie, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Just whatever pops up, I think it's a movie. So, yeah.
Right.
Anyway, interesting.
Yeah, okay. we don't have long, but your eldest son just started high school, is that right?
He did, yes. He's in year nine now. He's 14. Oh. He's actually 6'2", so,
what?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, he pats me on the head and says, "You're not going to grow anymore, Dad." So he's going well. Raph and Sadie and Tess, you're at home watching this, so Daddy will be home soon. keep the door locked.
We're not entirely sure Daddy will be home soon.
But Daddy will be home soon. Daddy's getting an Uber home. Although, can I get a cab charge?
Hughesy is heading around the country with his new show, Fully Furnished. All the details are on our website. Would you please thank Dave Hughes?